usually asked me a couple of times if I wanted to write an article for Smashing Magazine. And I wrote an article that got published in November 2015 by Smashing Magazine. I did a simple test. I took Smashing Magazine, I ripped off all the HTML and put it on Netlify. And then I run a couple of online benchmarks on it and published the results. And you could see that even if Smashing Magazine is one of the most optimized WordPress blogs out there, just putting it on a content delivery network in a static version would give you around 6 times the performance in terms of the time it takes to actually load the HTML from different places in the world. That's a big deal. And I guess it was one of the things that Vitaly and Marcus noticed and that really made them think, like, hey, what if we actually did this?
One of the reasons to move to Netlify is that we were having 4 different platforms. We were using a shop platform, we were using WordPress, we were using a platform for running our job board, and we were also using a 4th CMS to run our conference site. And this is insane.
We actually always stayed on WordPress, and it was kind of the core. And basically everything was on top of, you know, the regular LAMP stack. There was nothing fancy going on. We had some caching issues every now and again. We tested probably every single WordPress caching plugin out there. And we experienced problems with every single one of them.
We decided to try something new, to pioneer and to switch our platform from WordPress to a whole new stack. And that is where Netlify comes in.
Vitaly and Marcus from Smashing started talking to us and started explaining what they needed for this to be viable. Smashing needed a build tool for their magazine, a content management system, a comment engine, an e-commerce platform, a subscription service, and a member login. And they needed it within months. All the automation around this was provided by Netlify. But for each of these services, we needed to go look and see, like, what could we find out there? Were there something ready-made we could just plug in for Smashing's use case? And in this case, we didn't find anything. So we had to come up with a viable way of being able to build out all these things, have them be usable for the general community, and do it in a very efficient manner.
You don't have to rely on a combination of different platforms anymore. You can have it all in one place. And this is super unique. This is super new to the web development and design world.
JAMstack sites tend to be much faster for 2 reasons. One is that there's no build when you visit the site. The site is already there. And the other really important reason is that you can distribute it across the world on a content delivery network instead of having a central origin. Even a well-cached WordPress site that might skip some of those builds by having a cache in front of it will typically still have that cache on a single server in a single data center in the world, which means that from any other place in the world, you'll still get a very long latency.
The time to first load is so much faster than before. Like, before we had to wait for the HTML file being served like 800 milliseconds, and now it's like 80 milliseconds.
So main platform requirements for us are being able to deliver things quickly. So we want to be able to iterate and evolve things. We also want to make sure that users have a nice integrated experience. So when they want to check out, for example, they can do it really smoothly. That they feel like they are a part of the Smashing community and that they are in the Smashing universe.
We saw that there were some holes in the ecosystem that we needed to fill. So we built these open source APIs to work specifically with JAMstack sites. And we built this content management system to work specifically with JAMstack sites. And we really feel that that's something that will open up the possibilities of what you can build with this approach.
with Smashing Magazine, I have like the best process ever, and I have Matt to thank for that. I didn't have to worry about, okay, I've built this, now what? I didn't have to think about that next step, because the step that I was in is the final step. So I was building the final thing there.
Instead of taking Sarah's work and stuffing it into a CMS somewhere else, we're bringing a CMS into this flow, and we're bringing the content editors into this flow around GitHub and around pull requests and branches, but without the pain of actually having to know about Git or GitHub or anything technical. And that's really, really powerful.
Matt set it up in a way that everything that I push to the repository is being directly applied to the pattern library, which means that you don't have to maintain two different sets of components. Like, you don't have to maintain a pattern library, and then every time something changes in there, you have to go to wherever that pattern is used and update it there again. This continuity, like, for me, all I have to do is I just write HTML, CSS, JavaScript, push to the repository, and everything works like magic. The workflow was fantastic for each and everyone involved, so I couldn't be happier with it. It was amazing.
It's not just a much simpler solution, it also enables Smashing Magazine to actually be the pioneers they've always been, and to be able to preach what they practice and show developers how do you actually build websites with modern best practices and have them live directly on a content delivery network, eliminate the problems around security and scalability that traditional approaches have had, and get a much simpler flow for the front-end developers that actually work on the products. If we had built this as a traditional monolithic app for smashing, it would have been a super specific smashing project that would just be useful for smashing. And that was important to us to take on this project, that we made sure that everything we built is something that can be used by a much broader community than just the Smashing website.
We're giving something to the community while benefiting from it as well.
Smashing Magazine has always been about the best practices for web developers. So bringing them onto our platform is, of course, a huge pat on the back for us and a huge validation, and we think we must be doing something right. But it's also much bigger than us. It's about building a viable infrastructure to make the JAMstack approach power a majority of the web.
It felt like with Netlify we had exactly the metrics that I always wanted to have. Always wanted to have. After a few tests, it looked really, really good, because we could end up with exactly what we wanted in terms of flexibility, in terms of speed, in terms of performance, in terms of architecture for our front end.
We were able to unify like the shop, the magazine and memberships in just one place. And we did it with the help of Netlify. Without, we probably wouldn't have even been thinking about it.